And there are two correct answers here. One is that we can use non-determinism to guess a shortest tour. It's not totally obvious how to do that, because the if-better function always can only do two distinctions. So you have to find a clever way to use that function to guess how to construct a shortest tour, but it's possible in the way that I showed you here. Then once the shortest tour has been guessed, checking if the length is shorter than d, and as you'll remember, d was the maximum length that we allow for it, because we're having shortest tour as a decision problem. Once the shortest tour has been guessed, it's easy to check if the length of that tour is smaller than d. So by easy, I mean it's possible in polynomial time. So this one here is also correct. Non-determinism can be used to guess which vertices to put in the tour. Is obviously doesn't make sense, because all vertices are part of the tour. It's the order of the vertices that matters for solving shortest tour. And then the final one, of course, that was easy to see that it's not really a viable answer. But I wanted to point out to you that even though it might sometimes be obvious, you should always make sure to explicitly show that the problem is in NP. And we'll actually later in this course come across some problems where you might initially think that they are in NP, but actually they're much harder than problems that are in NP. So now we have completed the first step. We know that shortest tour is in NP. And now comes the part of finding a polynomial time reduction from an NP-complete problem to show that shortest tour is NP-complete.